OK, mais le remplaçant arrive quand?
Je passe à travers mes listes. Il n'y a personne de disponible. Personne ne veut entrer ici après ce qui est arrivé. Là.
Monsieur Lazhar, je viens pour le poste.
C'est juste qu'il y a des procédures à suivre.
J'ai enseigné pendant 19 ans dans une école primaire à Alger. Et moi, je suis disponible tout de suite.
After the suicide of a teacher in a Montreal school, a class of shocked and grieving students is thrown together with a 55-year-old Algerian immigrant with tragic secrets of his own who becomes their new teacher. The film Monsieur Lazhar tells a story of cultural gaps and emotional chasms in one small classroom and out into the wider world. The film was adapted from a one-act play and received an Oscar nomination for Best Foreign Language Film, and it opens in U.S. theaters Friday, April 13th. Its director, Philippe Falardeau.
That's right.
Joins us now. Welcome to you.
You get 10 points for that.
10 points, okay. Welcome to you. Tell us a little bit more about the story itself. The aftermath of a horrible event, and then what?
Well, it's based on a one-man play, and when I saw the play 5 years ago, I was not scouting for any film, for a subject for a film, but I fell in love with the main character. A mixture of humanity and dignity and fragility also because of his background, refugee from Algeria. And I wanted to tell a story from his point of view. And I had been looking for a point of entry into the topic of immigration, but every time I had an idea, it was too didactic. But there I was in front of a character whose main, you know, focus was his humanity and how he could help the children grieve.
Well, that's interesting. I was wondering if you started with a desire for something big like immigration. And, of course, there is a sort of backstory we can't go into, but in Algeria of political repression. But it all is set in one small setting, right, in a classroom.
I think that's why the film worked at the end of the day. It's because it's not about immigration. Yeah. He is an immigrant, so who he is and his background enriched the character, but it's really about what's happening in the school. And you and I have been to school. All the audience, you know, everyone in the audience has been to school. So we all have our personal point of entry into that story. So I don't think people go to cinema to see ideas or topics. They go to follow a story and they relate to characters, not ideas.
Well, part of the story, of course, is about dealing with emotions, strong emotions and strong tragedy, and our inability to deal with it, right? And one of the things in this film is that it's almost as though we're not allowed to talk about it, the students, that is. The adults don't want to talk about it, only for the psychologists. Something in our society that doesn't allow that.
We try to have a protocol for every situation possible, and it's especially true at school. And I think what the film is saying basically is that we should let the teachers invest their own class and let them deal with the stuff that's happening on a daily basis. And how do you deal with drama when drama is so big like that at school? And I think the best person to deal with that, it's the person who accompanies the children in every day. And the film is poking a little bit on the education system and what I think is too many rules and regulation, but it is really an ode to the work of teachers.
Mm-hmm. Now this main character, and you said you were sort of taken by him right away. I mean, one thing we learned at the beginning is that he really has no clue about teaching.
No, he doesn't.
And he has and then as we slowly learn that he has some real tragedy in his own life that he doesn't want to talk about.
I like the fact that this character tells the truth to the immigration officer. He doesn't have any choice. And he lies at school, but for a good reason. He instinctively knows that he can help these children because of his background, help the children grieve, and he also needs that for himself. And I think any sensible person can teach young children, you know, how to read and how to write, but teaching is much more than that. And that's the other thing that the film is trying to convey, that teaching is much more than just learning how to read and to write. It's the school is really an incubator for human beings, you know. It's a mini laboratory of what happens in life in general.
You know, I'm imagining that people listening to this and hearing about the story, it could easily be and have been a very sentimental tale, but it is not.
I mean, I have seen it. No, it's not melodramatic.
It is not at all, to I think your great credit. Was it something you were worried about?
I was, because when you look at the premise, you know, refugee,
right?
You know, tragedy, replaces a teacher that commits suicide, and say, wow, this is a dark premise. Yeah. I wanted the film to be luminous. Visually, I think it is. Yeah. The music pulls the movie, you know, towards the light, and the humor. There is actually humor in that film, although it's not a comedy. So it was important for me for the film to be luminous.
And remarkable actors. The adult, Mohamed Felag.
Yes.
And then these children, who are kind of extraordinary. How did you find them, and what was it like working with children?
When you make a film, you can make mistakes. When you're shooting, with the light, with the editing, you can make small mistakes, and you'll get away with it. You cannot make mistakes casting the film. And I wanted someone to play the immigrant who would be instant, you know, the other, the person we don't know, the Algerian on screen, the first minute. And I think I found that man in Felag, who actually also fled his own country in the 1990s because of the Civil War. So he had an intimate relation with that character. And the kids, well, you know, kids will go a long way if they trust you. So for me, it's about meeting them in the audition process, not just putting them in front of camera and say, do your line, thank you very much. I'm taking the time. And on the set, it's just pretending we're at summer camp and let them know that they can have fun. And when it's time to work, they trust you and they can reach deep down inside of them to grab a piece of their own, you know, life emotion.
Were there moments where you thought, what have I done? I mean, how am I going to get these kids to be the characters you want?
It's something that you try not to think about. And I always watch a François Truffaut movie day for night every time I'm ready to shoot a film. And because
I was thinking of you know the film Small Change?
Yes.
You must know that as well.
Of course, François Truffaut. Yeah. And also I was inspired by Au revoir les enfants from Louis Malle. Yeah. But Truffaut in the movie Day for Night, it's about the story of a director who's directing a film, and he says, every time I start a movie, I want to make the best film possible. But when it starts, I just want to finish it. Yeah. And it's you're on a mission when you're making a movie, so you're not trying to overthink everything, but you certainly, when you deal with emotion and children like that, you kind of keep your fingers crossed that, you know, the scenes will happen. And in that particular, I was lucky, you know, things happen.
Let me ask you finally, I gather, for I didn't know this until I was just reading about you, but you're sort of an accidental filmmaker.
Yeah, I studied political science and international relations, so it's kind of exciting for me to be in Washington right now. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I participated in this contest 20 years ago at the public television, where they sent every year 8 young contestants with a camera. We were traveling alone, and we had to do 20 short films in 20 weeks. And I came back from that, and I wanted to make films.
This film is Monsieur Lazhar, Philippe Falardeau. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us again on Artbeat. I'm Jeffrey Brown.